Beck is a 26-episode anime broadcast between 2004 and 2005, directed by Osamu Kobayashi and adapted from the manga of the same name by Harold Sakuishi, artistic name of Takahiro Sakuishi, inspired by the wrestler Harold Sakata, renowned for his role as Odd Job in the movie Goldfinger. Sakuishi's debut work, Gorillaman, directly draws inspiration from Harold Sakata. This work blends elements of bizarre humor with more serious and touching moments, exploring the personal growth and determination of the protagonist, Rando Rinozuka, who is dedicated to realizing his dream of becoming a successful wrestler. These characteristics have become a distinctive signature of Harold Sakuishi's style and are fundamental in Beck. The main character is Yukio Tanaka, nicknamed Koyuki, a 14-year-old boy tired of his decidedly dull and uneventful life. One day, while rescuing an abused dog, he encounters Ryusuke Minami, who, as a gesture of gratitude, gives him a guitar. This event marks the beginning of Koyuki's journey into the world of music. With the help of Taira, Chiba, and Saku, Koyuki and Ryusuke form an underground band called Beck. From this point on, the story unfolds along two main themes, branching into subtler but impactful subplots: the band's journey in the music industry, and Koyuki's personal growth, the true driving force behind the entire narrative. Beck is populated with original and excellently characterized characters. Due to time constraints, I will only tell you about three of them. Koyuki. Despite being an ordinary Japanese student, his talent as a singer is so impressive that it even captivates famous musicians worldwide. When not playing the guitar, he adopts a performance style similar to Liam Gallagher of Oasis, crossing his hands behind his back. During his school years, he's a victim of bullying, but Sakuishi portrays Koyuki as an honest and inexperienced boy. In doing so, these episodes are easily overcome by simply forgetting them, as music is more important than anything else. Bullying is nothing more than a weak, semi-transparent obstacle in Koyuki's path. Another discipline that strongly influences Koyuki is swimming. This side story harmoniously connects various narrative threads: feelings for Izumi, physical growth, encountering a mentor, bullying, and of course, music. Swimming contributes to developing lung capacity, thereby improving vocal abilities. Maho Minami. Maho is the first to recognize Koyuki's talent and constantly supports him. Despite behaving like a couple in some situations, due to their age, they never openly declare their bond, even though Ryusuke gives condoms to Koyuki more than once. The dimension of the unsaid forms the core and beauty of their feelings. It will take a total of 26 episodes, approximately 2 fictional years, to make their relationship official. Izumi Ishiguro. Izumi is a passionate fan of the dying breed. She introduces Koyuki to the existence of the band, thus influencing his life and musical career. After Koyuki starts attending another high school, they drift apart. She secretly harbored love for him, but realizes it too late, in front of Maho, she voluntarily withdraws. The beauty of Izumi's character, as well as many others, is that at some point, she abandons the narrative line. Izumi continues to study, meet new people, and follow her own path as a typical Japanese girl, which is a different path from Kayuki's. Knowing her and getting attached to her, maybe rooting for her, makes it painful to part ways. But that's life. And Harold Sakuishi has masterfully told this story. It takes courage and clarity to erase a character. Beck prefers silences, listening shots, and scenes where music takes the lead. Establishing shots are frequently repeated, with subtle variations in lighting. However, the leitmotif that distinguishes the rhythm is the crossfades and fades to black. These choices clearly emphasize the passage of time, the main catalyst for the nostalgia that permeates the entire work. For this reason, there's always a slight flutter of the heart whenever Maho and Koyuki meet, and a jolt every time Beck takes the stage. The series doesn't shine in terms of animation, but this doesn't diminish the overall quality of the work. The production rightly focused on the soundtrack. Beck is composed of numerous still images, slow zooms, and panning shots. Nevertheless, there is a truly extraordinary sequence that I believe is worth quoting in full, in honor of those who dedicated themselves wholeheartedly to this moment. It's interesting to note that in the original work, the scene is given 2 pages, while in the animated adaptation, they put in a great effort. Particularly, the use of slow motion in the shot, where Koyuki knocks on the window, enhances the sequence. Episode 5. Koyuki is still an amateur with the guitar, but thanks to his teacher Saito, he participates in a competition that turns out to be rigged. If they lose, the penalty is to strip naked. At the end of the performance, a brief narrative interlude where we don't hear the dialogues prepares us for the next moment. What they say can only be imagined. A crossfade takes us to the school's long shot. Cut, detail of the gate. Cut, the moon reflected in the pool water. Acting as a sound bridge is the noise of Koyuki and Maho climbing over the fence. Koyuki, in extreme close-up, puts his feet down and turns. With his point-of-view shot, we see Maho naked inviting him to dive in. The ellipsis that took us from the performance to Maho naked indicates only one thing. They lost. The staging used to keep the promise and the intimacy that is created are astonishing. Yeah! Maho dives in. Swims a few meters and starts singing.
Maho, koe ga oki yo. Dareka ni miraretara.
Full moon sway.
the moon in the sky, the reflected moon. Koyuki finally decides to dive, and again, the action is eliminated. We see clothes on the ground and the dive.
Yep.
With great awareness and empathy, Kobayashi stays for 2 minutes and 15 seconds on the moon, its reflection, and a pan of the grass blades moved by the wind. All brief loops of a few seconds. In the background, Maho and Koyuki sing. At this moment, the director is engaged in telling a first time. Like the two protagonists probably not looking at each other, perhaps due to natural embarrassment, we also look with them at the landscape. Now, at the end, here's Koyuki, in close-up looking off-screen. Maho returns the gaze. They are not framed together. The tension is palpable. A voice brings them back to reality. It's Mr. Saito, also naked, hanging on the fence. He stole the competition's prize. Episode 12. The Dying Breed is in Japan for a tour. Eddie, the band's guitarist and a close friend of Ryusuke, has invited the entire band to the concert. The initial shots capture the aesthetics of a live performance, with the addition of a filter that shifts towards blue and burns the highlights. This visual treatment, besides being quite realistic, is also the only time it is used in the entire series, as if it were a point of view of the band. During a break, Matt, the frontman, spots Koyuki in the crowd. Having heard him sing in the previous episode, Matt invites him to come on stage.
Come on. All right, you gotta sing with us.
All eyes are on him. A vertical panning frames Koyuki in the center of these eccentric characters, and then a semi-point of view shot, a sea of astonished heads. Koyuki is too excited and completely off key. The audience mocks him, but the band gives it another try. Sidetracking shot. Only parallax. No animation. He starts singing. Close-up reaction shot of Maho. Just a few frames to capture her changing expression. Shivers. In a very long shot, the appreciation begins. A series of fades take us on a journey between the moon and the listening shots of the audience. This choice proves highly effective in conveying Koyuki's thoughts, instantly transporting him back to the night he went skinny dipping with Maho and showcasing the immense appreciation he is receiving. In a production where the budget was allocated to the soundtrack, showing poor animation on the singer is risky. It's more effective to leverage static reaction shots as emotional catalysts. After all, as film history teaches us, it's often the reaction shots that emerge as the true protagonists. Close-up of Koyuki, a few frames that give soul to the character. Medium shot from behind at a Dutch angle of Koyuki singing under the spotlight. Above him, a light in the venue resembles the moon he is addressing. Crossfade to the moon. Fade to black. We'll be right back. Despite the anime stopping at a third of the original work, I consider it a must-watch. I've read some rather negative comments about the ending and the treatment of the narrative arc of the tour in America. Personally, I greatly appreciated Kobayashi's inventiveness, who in the last episode managed to salvage an otherwise incomplete work, giving us a noteworthy conclusion. Due to the lack of budget to produce new episodes and the absence of material to adapt, the manga concludes in 2008 while the anime in 2005, Kobayashi narrates the journey to America through a flashback using photographs taken by the band during the tour. These amateur, imperfect, blurry, and amusing photos serve as the backdrop, with Maho and Koyuki providing commentary on each one. The power of cinema in all its glory. Synthesis. This device works because we are already well acquainted with the characters, having focused on the emotions of each of them in the previous episodes. This allows the use of off-screen elements to delve into our emotions. And why not? Bring a few tears for the end of a wonderful story. I hope for a second season one day.